Today I'm going to make a plane, and it's going to be a Japanese style plane. I've never made a plane before, and I've never used a Japanese style plane either. My boy the other day was trying to plane with a number 4 Stanley, and he was struggling a little bit with it, and I wondered whether a Japanese style plane may be easier. I'm not sure if that's the case, but that's the reason I'm going to make one. Plus, I've always wanted to make a plane, I've just never got around to it. I'm going to use one of these old plane blades that I picked up from a flea market. I'm not sure how much I paid for them, but it wouldn't have been much. I've got the blade into a half decent state. It still needs sharpening properly, but what I need to do is add some mass to the back of the blade, and to do that I've got this piece of mild steel, and I'm going to glue that with JB Weld. I've never used it before, but I think it's supposed to be pretty good, and there's a large surface area, so I don't think there'll be too much of a problem there. But before I do that, what I need to do is I need to shape this piece. It needs to end up as a wedge. So I've got to remove quite a lot of material there, and I don't have a metal bandsaw, so I'm just gonna have to keep going with the grinder. I have thinner steel, but that was too thin, and this is too thick. And then the other thing is it's just a little bit narrower as well. So once I've got the shape of this, I'll weld a piece onto the side of it, and then do the final shaping, and then glue it together. It's really starting to come together, and it feels pretty good. I've done some sharpening, but it needs more. It obviously isn't going to be as good as a top quality blade, but I'm hoping that we can get some good shavings with it. So we'll just see how it goes. I've just watched one of the Samurai Carpenters videos on how to set up a Japanese plane. And what I found out, I learned something, and I always do learn something on his videos, is that the back of the blade needs hollowing slightly, so when that's bedded in the plane, it stops any chance of any sideways movement in the plane. So I'm going to take an angle grinder and take a few light passes off there. I don't think I need to take too much off, and I'll keep dunking it in water to keep it cool, so I don't think I'm going to affect the edge there. It'll just be light passes. I reckon that came out really well. The only thing left to do is to grind the two corners off, and then the blade is finished. Yes. The next job is to fit the chip breaker, and I need to put a bar across there so the chip breaker wedges in there. And I've just found this old sieve here. I do use it to strain paint. It was around the back of my shed, and I've stolen a little piece of bar from that. As you can see, that turned out pretty awesome. I understand that it's not a top quality tool, but for something I made, I think it turned out pretty well, and I'm very happy with it. I even think Bradley found it a little bit easier to use. He probably still needs to improve his technique, which I probably do as well. So hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like and subscribe. And if you'd like to support me, you could always buy one of my t-shirts or support me on Patreon. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.